weighing 214 pounds, Long Island Iced Tea, Zach Ryder.
Well, we need something to lighten the mood out here a little bit. I mean, the actions of Chris Jericho, absolutely reprehensible.
And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome at this time, Alberto Del Rio's personal ring announcer, Ricardo Rodriguez.
Look at that hair.
I love that guy.
Hey, wait till you see the ride Del Rio's got here today in Washington.
I had the opportunity to actually sit in this car earlier today. It is a 2011 Mercedes SLS AMG worth $240,000.
That make you feel know that your life savings is in your car's ashtray.
Damas y caballeros, es un honor presentarles a ustedes a este hombre, a esta leyenda, a este dios de la lucha libre, desde la esencia de Iglesia, el hombre de México, el patrón, Alberto.
Folks, Del Rio really in the eye of the storm of one of the most controversial stories in the entire WWE Universe. Been buzzing about what transpired Friday night on SmackDown. Del Rio's return to the show versus the world champion, Sheamus. Now, well, Ricardo Rodriguez will distract Sheamus momentarily. This would allow Del Rio to introduce the chair. Now, the referee was back dealing with Rodriguez, and he would catch Sheamus red-handed, or so we thought. Del Rio introduced the chair. Sheamus would sucker it in. The referee only saw that result. He made a judgment call. He had Sheamus disqualified. Sheamus completely lost it. And watch what Sheamus does to referee Chad Patton here. He's a loose cannon. And as Rodriguez is celebrating, Sheamus would go absolutely berserk. Sheamus delivering the bro kick to the referee. And because of this, officials all over the WWE are up in arms. Many are calling for the firing of Sheamus in exclusive interviews on WWE.com.
Well, the referee obviously made a wrong decision, but so did Sheamus. You cannot do something like that to an official here. And we understand that severe repercussions are going to be coming tomorrow night live on Sci-Fi on SmackDown's Blast from the Past for Sheamus, well, for General Manager John Laurinaitis.
Here's the cover by Del Rio. Zack Ryder kicking out, of course, tomorrow night's Super SmackDown Live, Blast from the Past on Sci-Fi, 8, 7 Central Live, as Del Rio delivers the drop kick to the skull. Hook of the leg on Ryder, who kicks out yet again.
I'd hate to know what kind of repercussions, as they say, John Laurinaitis is going to come up with.
And I do want to point out, you see the WWE Raw is going on tour for the next 2 weeks internationally, including, for the first time ever, Wednesday night in Moscow, Russia. For the first time ever.
Moscow. There are no cows. Right?
That's what I said.
You said Moscow.
Not really, but nonetheless, Del Rio hammering away on Ryder.
This Del Rio. Oh. Hey, I'll look say he needs to get what he's got coming. He may get it right here. Come on, Zach.
Ryder's got Del Rio in line, perhaps for the broski.
Got it, connects! Oh, man!
And Zach Ryder looking to pull off a big upset here.
Oh, man!
Del Rio in trouble.
You're not kidding. Ryder just jacked his jaw.
Zach Ryder going for the Rough Rider, and Del Rio sends him flying.
Man.
And out Del Rio. He'll roll over, throw it into the cross arm breaker. A submission maneuver. Ryder taps out. He's got no choice. SmackDown's Alberto Del Rio victorious here tonight on Raw.
Boy, I got to give that guy credit. Alberto took a heck of a shot right here. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. That would have knocked out a normal man. But somehow, Alberto Del Rio able to get his wits about it. Sends Zack Ryder face first into that turnbuckle, and then this. It's tap out time. Let's take one more look. Look at this kick by Zack Ryder. I mean, right on the money. Wow. But how Del Rio came back from that, I don't know.
Alberto Del Rio victorious here on Monday Night Raw. And the bad couple of weeks continues for that man, Zack Ryder.